Today, I'll show you an officially supported way to customize your Home Assistant dashboard by adding actionable pictures, buttons, and graphs in the headers and footers of your Home Assistant cards, so you can convert the standard and boring card like this into something like this. These customizations can be done without doing anything special, like installing additional custom components, using hacks, or other complicated stuff, as everything comes out of the box with Home Assistant and you just have to configure it. After you finish watching this video, you'll be able to add widgets with pictures, buttons, and graphs in the header or footer of the Home Assistant cards. These widgets will not only look cool, but you'll be able to define different actions for tap, double tap, and hold on the pictures. You'll be able to set material design icons for the buttons, and you can display detailed graphs. Without further ado, let's start this video. I will use this entity card, which have two lights and one switch, one WLED light and one Shelly bulb dual light, as well as one Shelly switch. Just quick warning before we continue further. Not all of the Home Assistant dashboard cards have support for header and footer widgets. I will use an entity card for the sake of this demo. I'll click on the three dots menu and I'll edit the dashboard. Then I'll edit the card and I'll tap on this plus button next to the header label. I'll select a picture and immediately one picture is added with these balloons by default. This is the web URL of the picture where it is located. And if I like this picture, I can just click save and this is my new card. How cool is that? This picture is hosted somewhere on the Home Assistant servers. That means your Home Assistant should be connected to the internet to display this card. Of course, you can upload that or any other picture locally and to use it that way, which is a lot better if you ask me. Here is how you can do it. I'll first download this picture. Of course, I can use any other picture I wish. But I'll try with this one first. I'll cancel this. I'll paste the URL in a different tab and I'll save the image on my computer. Okay, I'm ready with that part. Then I'll open my file editor add-on and I'll create one directory here. This directory will be named www. So the whole path will be config www. If you already have such folder, of course you don't have to create it again, you just have to upload some pictures inside. But because I'm creating it right now, I have to restart my Home Assistant so I can use it. I'll go to configuration, settings, restart. Okay, Home Assistant has started. I'll go again to my file editor add-on. I'll go inside this newly created www folder and I'll upload my file, my picture, the balloons header.png. You just have to restart Home Assistant only once, the first time you created the www folder, and after that you can freely use it. The balloons header was successfully uploaded. Now I can go back to the overview. I'll edit the card again and I'll edit the header and instead this whole URL here. Actually, I'll use the name, I'll delete the rest because my picture name is the same, and I'll just type here local. Local is equal to config slash www folder. So as you can see, my balloons are visible and I can freely click save. That way, this picture is now local and I don't have to use internet to access this picture. Everything stays on the Home Assistant server. Okay, we have a picture in the header and our Home Assistant dashboard is looking different already. Pretty similar, we can add a picture in the footer. Here is how. For the footer, I'll edit my card again. This time I'll tap on this plus next to the footer. I'll select picture again and the balloons are immediately displayed, but I'll change them. I'll delete the URL of the balloons and I'll type local slash and I'll paste the name of one picture of me that I uploaded in the same folder, config/www. And here it is. This is how my cart is looking now. I just have to click save. Very nice. I like it. Of course, these pictures can be anything you wish. And if you find or you already have some cool cart pictures for Home Assistant, can you please share them in the comment section below? If more of us are willing to share something in the comments, it will become a very useful resource. I will share my silly picture down below in case some crazy dude wants to use it on his dashboards, and I'm dying to see your pictures there as well. The pictures that we are talking about so far are not just making your Home Assistant dashboard more beautiful and colorful. You can also assign different actions when click, double click, or hold your mouse on them. Let's see how. Okay, let's see if we can use this picture for something useful. I'll edit the cart again. I'll select the footer, for example. Here I have two actions, tap action and hold action. Let's try the hold action, for example. I'll change this from none. The possible options are URL, call service, toggle, navigate, and more info. So you can use all of these actions. They are well described in the Home Assistant documentation. I will leave a link in the description if you wish to understand more. I'll just demonstrate a few of these actions. For the rest, you can check the documentation. For example, let's try with the URL. When I change the text of the action, immediately there is configuration error and this screen is immediately changed, which is very annoying. And I have to find my hold action. Here it is actually. I'll change it to URL. Now everything is fine again, but I also have to add few more things. For example, URL path colon, and then I'll just have to type the URL that I want to go. For example, https://payansky.com. I think I'm ready. So when I hold on this picture, I should open my website. Let's see. Save. Tap and hold. Release. And payansky.com is open in a new tab. Great. Let's see one more action. I'll edit the cart again. This time, let's try the header, the balloons. I'll call a service this time. So I'll change the action to call service. Again the error, again the screen is changed. I'll continue typing call-service. Then I have to type the service that I want to invoke. It can be any Home Assistant service. For example, light toggle. After that, I have to add service data. And this service data should have an entity ID. Let's say my entity will be this one. ShellyBubDo. I'll paste it right here and I think I'm ready. Now when I tap on the balloons, the ShellyBubDo should be toggled. Save. Let's see. It is working. Great. That's perfect. There is also an option to present a confirmation dialog to confirm the action. You can even customize this dialog. Let me show you one more thing with the pictures before we move on. I'll edit the cart again. I'll edit the header. And inside tap action, I'll type confirmation colon Where is my confirmation? Here it is. True. Confirmation, colon, true. Save. Now, if I tap on the balloons, I'll see this confirmation dialog. Are you sure you want to run action light toggle? I can click cancel and I can click OK. You can even customize the dialog. I'll delete this. And I'll type text colon, are you sure? And I'll delete the no value. I think that's fine. Save. Let's test this. Yes, it is working. Are you sure? Okay, and cancel. Enough about pictures. Let's see the buttons now. That was Home Assistant dashboard customization by adding pictures in the header and footer. Before we continue with the button widgets, I want to share what I did to help you further in your smart home journey. I've put together a glossary, simply called the Smart Home Glossary, and I want to give it to you absolutely free. Inside this glossary, you can find the most important smart home words, abbreviations, and acronyms. Each item will have a simple but useful and understandable description. You can instantly download that smart home glossary on my website, automatelikepro.com/glossary. Now, back to the Home Assistant dashboard customization using button widgets in the header and footer of the cards. Let's see the button widgets in the cards. I'll edit the card again. I'll delete the header, for example. I'll tap on the plus button and this time I'll choose buttons. And now I can make a list of buttons that will be displayed in my header. This annoying error again. I'll use this script toggle all lights, which is very simple. It will actually toggle all of my lights. You can invoke a scene or automation here. If you enter one more entity, let's do it like that. It will add another button in the header card. I'll save the card and I'll just quickly show you the script that I'm using. You can use any script that you wish. I'll go to automation and scenes. This is my script. It is very simple, just for the demo. It is calling the service light toggle and it toggles these both entities here. As YAML is looking like that. Again, let's go back. I added these two buttons, which actually is invoking this script that I just showed you. If I click on the button, all of the lights are turned on. The button icons used in the headers and footers can be further customized by using any icon from Material Design website. This allows further customization of your Home Assistant card and dashboard. It is far more meaningful if you have an icon that represents the action that the button actually is doing. If I edit the card, I can add icons that are more meaningful to me. Icon column, where is my icon? MDI column, a light bulb multiple, for example. And now I have multiple bulbs. I can also add an icon to the second button, but I think that's fine. Now I have two buttons and if I click on them, they'll just work. Of course, I can add buttons to my footer as well. As entity, you can use any script, scene, or automation that you wish and have in Home Assistant. For example, you can create a custom scene and assign this scene on the one of the buttons, so when pressed, only specific lights to be toggled. The possible options are endless, and I'm leaving this fun to you. And I'm moving to the graphs that can be also added as headers and footers of the Home Assistant cards. Here is how. to demonstrate you the graphs, I'll use this entity card where I'm showing my humidity and temperature using my Broadlink RM4 Pro device. I'll click Edit. I'll tap on the plus button next to the header and I'll select graph. Now I just have to search for a suitable entity. I'll type humidity and here it is. I can show more details and I can change the hours to show, for example 12. It doesn't matter, I'll just click save and this is my humidity shown as graph on my card. Exactly as with the pictures and buttons, you can add a graph to the header or footer of the card. Let's see the footer, plus button again, graph, and this time I'll search for temperature and I'll leave the temperature without enabling this show more detail and I'll just click save. And now I have a card showing the graph of my humidity and temperature and it is looking pretty cool. By the way, if you have difficulties understanding the different Home Assistant installation types, I have a free webinar just for you. In the webinar, I'm talking about the official Home Assistant installation methods, plus one secret and stupid easy way to have Home Assistant. You can register for the webinar and you can instantly start watching it on my website, automatelike.pro/webinar. Again, it is totally free. Hope that video was useful. I'm Kirill and I'm done speaking. Bye!